Many customers want to take advantage of the scale and power of the cloud to run SAP HANA. Now you can use Terraform and Ansible to speed up your deployments on Azure. Get going in as little as 30 minutes instead of hours or days. Paige is here to show us how it works today on Azure Friday. Hey everyone, Donovan Brown here with another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Paige, and she's going to show us how to deploy SAP HANA into Azure. So why would someone want to run SAP HANA in Azure?
So SAP HANA is a product, a database product that a lot of different customers like to use for managing transactions or different things. The reason they would want to run it in Azure is a lot of companies are moving toward the cloud.
Sure.
It's very difficult right now and can be kind of a tedious process to do a manual installation into any sort of VM, whether it be Azure or a different cloud provider. But our tool aims to make that a lot simpler by limiting the number of steps that the user will have to take.
Okay. And so this is something that would normally take, what, an order of minutes, hours, days? How long does a normal deployment take?
The deployment itself using the script takes about half an hour.
Okay.
But when you have someone manually having to type in things on the computer, it can take a matter of hours. If someone's very unfamiliar, it can take order of magnitude of days.
Wow. And this is just for a single node, or is this like some like a clustered such scenario? What do people look for?
This is for a single node. It can take even longer for a cluster or for an HA pair, which we also have available on our GitHub repo, but I'm just not going into detail about it today.
Great. So we have scripts not only for the one you're going to show us today, but for a more complicated scenario as well, which will still drastically reduce the amount of time it takes to deploy. Awesome. So can you show me how it works?
Sure. So if you go to our GitHub repo, it's github.com/azure/SAP-HANA. So if you go onto our page, you'll see that our deployment script is broken down into Terraform modules, which we use to deploy the infrastructure components, like the Azure resources. And then the Ansible playbooks run different roles to install and configure SAP HANA. So to actually mount the disks that we're creating and get the database running, all that activity happens in Ansible.
Okay, gotcha.
So if we scroll down on the Getting Started page, you can see we can run this even from Cloud Shell, or you can use a local machine. But I'm going to show, for the sake of the demo, deployment in Cloud Shell.
Okay.
Then there are a number of input variables that you need to put in. So I'm just going to show this text file with all the, this is sort of a template of the variables that you would need to input into Terraform before running the deployment script. So you can specify what region you would like the deployment to go into. You can specify the resource group. You need to give some service principal like credentials for your Azure login. You can specify how big you would like the VM to be. For example, here we say that we would like to run on a standard 8S V3. Mm-hmm. So you can specify and change it based on the size and needs that you would like to have with your database. You can also specify how many disks you would like to have. And there are different tools that are SAP products that you can opt to install on top of HANA that we have optional flags to do that as well.
Got it. So filling out this script is, filling out this file is basically my way of saying these are all the inputs that are going to be needed.
Yeah.
I can do that right now versus being prompted during the installation itself.
Gotcha. Yes.
I can review this, make sure it's good, and then I can be able to use this exact file inside of Cloud Shell, where Ansible's already running inside of Cloud Shell.
Yeah, Ansible's already installed inside of Cloud Shell. The only thing that you have to do is export a few variables, which are listed in the README documentation to make sure that all of your information is in there to run smoothly. But Ansible and Terraform are both already installed.
Perfect.
All you have to do is clone the repo and then fill out this file.
Awesome. Okay.
So do you want to move on to...
Sure, I'd love to see it.
Okay, so if you go to the... If you go to Azure Cloud Shell, I've already cloned the repo, so I'm just gonna, I wrote a little script that will load my credentials, so I'm gonna run that quickly so I don't have to type them into the computer.
So you came into Cloud Shell, you used the Git, and you cloned the repo, and you have it now down on your machine, or inside of Cloud Shell.
Inside of Cloud Shell.
Perfect.
So I just loaded in my credentials, which are the few steps that you need to take that are, I just don't want to put all of my passwords on the screen.
No problem.
Then I do, I go into the repo, into the deploy directory, then go specifically into the VM part. Then if you see, if you look here, there are three different directories. It's split into the Ansible roles and the Terraform modules.
Okay.
So we run the script from Terraform. So I'm going to go into the modules directory and then to the single node HANA deployment. So it, when you want to deploy, all you have to do is say Terraform plan, and this will give you an output of what resources you're going to deploy into Azure.
Okay.
Sometimes takes a second or two to get it to actually
no problem.
Load.
But Terraform is only going to provision the infrastructure,
correct.
Not actually configure the databases. That's what Ansible is going to do.
Correct.
But now, do I run two commands, or do I run
no.
this one command, and Terraform goes off and says, hey, okay, I'm done provisioning your infrastructure. Hey, Ansible, it's your turn. Go finish this.
Correct.
Okay, got
That's it. How it works. So you just have to do one command, and it calls everything.
Perfect.
So that did the plan. You can see all the different resources that are going to be created. It's going to make a VM. You're going to get your network security groups and all of the disks. So then to apply it, I just do Terraform apply. And I'm going to hit yes as soon as it asks me. It's going to give me the same list of resources that I just went over. So I just type in yes. And it should be on its way to start deploying your Azure resources.
Great. And because you gave it a resource group, when this is done, I can go to that resource group and I'll see everything that has
yeah.
been provisioned for me.
And if you want, we can start going over to
sure.
Portal
now. Sure,
one
that's already been done. Awesome.
So I called it Demo 3. And you can see that it's already starting to populate the different resources.
Okay.
It's going to keep populating as the script runs. So if I refresh, a few more are already
sure.
added. So you can see them actively.
Gotcha.
But it does take about half an hour for the actual demo to finish running.
Sure.
So I've pre-baked another scenario
awesome.
So I can show you guys the output.
Okay.
So this one is called Demo 2. It's very similar to Demo 3, except for that it's already ready to go.
Okay.
So you can see all these Azure resources have already been created. Then there are some specific HANA tools that you can use, or SAP products that we did enable the flags for
okay.
that I was talking about so that we can get some output from the database.
Okay.
So first I'm going to go into Shine, which is an SAP delivered demo content. So it's a way to show off kind of how the HANA database works. It's not a product that we wrote. It's one provided by SAP, but we do actually install it if you enable it so that you can get a nice demo like this. You probably wouldn't use it if you have your own data, but
yeah, it's also nice to see that the tools that were written for HANA work just as well if it's hosted in Azure as it would
yeah.
if you'd installed it yourself. So this
yeah.
is just an example of if it understands SAP HANA, it's going to understand it even if we host it for you in Azure.
Yes,
okay,
correct.
Got it. Okay.
So this is on the demo 2 that I loaded. So you can check. There are different, I have to sign in.
Sure.
And then there are different pieces, like the work purchase order work list and different types of graphs that you can get.
Okay.
So for example, these are purchase orders. I've heard it works kind of like Microsoft Contoso, like the fake Contoso
sure.
ads. So if you wanted to, you could even just select a purchase order. This is all mock data that this Shine tool generates for you. So
gotcha.
You don't actually have to come up with it yourself. It's all here. And you could say, for example, accept. And it will accept a purchase order. And whoops.
There we go.
And are we going? Okay. Now I would like to show you guys the sales dashboard. This is again another Shine demo content piece that the SAP Shine tool has given us. You can see a bunch of different graphs and purchase orders. This kind of
gotcha.
Also emulates different data tools that you would use if you installed an SAP application on top of your HANA
gotcha.
Database.
Right, because SAP itself wasn't installed in any way during the deployment. What we did is we deployed the back end that would then support your SAP. And what we did in this scenario is we took Shine and said, hey, I have this beautiful HANA database. Mm-hmm. Go connect yourself there, populate it with sample data so that I can now run you against it. But in a real world, I would say, okay, now I have my beautiful HANA database. Hey, SAP, there's your data source. And then I would just start using it like normal.
So SAP is the company
sure.
that provides
the HANA database.
The HANA database.
But not SAP, the product doesn't sit on top of that.
No, SAP
gotcha.
Provides different products that
gotcha.
In turn will then sit on top of the HANA database.
Perfect, got it. And this is, but Shine isn't what I would run against it. This is just for demo.
This is just for demo.
So what would I actually run against it, just for my own curiosity?
Like S4 HANA
gotcha.
Or one of the different products like NetWeaver. There are several different application tiers that you would run on top of it.
And you would just point them now at the Azure instance of your SAP HANA database for those products to use against.
Yes.
Got it. Okay, now I'm up to speed. I'm new to SAP myself.
No, right? Okay.
Cool.
So this is just some more demo data. You can see the data has been split into regions by the purchase orders. You can see like countries and different things about the demo data, but we don't have to spend too much time on the demo data.
Sure, because the point here was how quickly we're able to stand up the HANA database.
Yeah.
The fact that you can use Shine or whatever other products you want on top of it is just a value add, and it also just goes to the point that no matter where you're hosting it, it's just an SAP HANA database. So mm-hmm. you don't have to do anything special to get your existing tools to work with it. They're just going to work with it.
Yes.
Perfect. Awesome.
Okay. And then I'm going to show you Cockpit now, which is a way that you can monitor and administer different pieces of the database. It's a tool that SAP also provides that we they're going to use more now moving forward instead of the HANA Studio, which is their predecessor to Cockpit. So the difference is that HANA Studio runs on a machine itself, and it connects to the database. The HANA Cockpit runs in a web browser, and so you can connect to all the different pieces here. You can monitor, so you can see all the different memory usages and CPU usage. You can get a lot of different pieces of data on this.
And this is the kind of data that I'd want to review to see if I need to scale up or scale out my
Correct.
HANA database. Got it. Right. And then again, this is another product that's provided for me once I have my deployment done using the tools that you just showed us.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. So it's really cool that, because when I saw Terraform and Ansible, I'm familiar with those products. I'm like, oh man, now do I have to go install these too? But I keep forgetting how much power we actually have in the cloud shell.
Yeah.
That pretty much everything that you need or want is actually going to be already in there. Mm-hmm. So the steps, again, just to summarize, are clone the repo from cloud shell, fill in the few important bits for the security, and then go ahead and run the script in Terraform and sit back and relax.
Mm-hmm.
That's awesome. Thank you so much for coming here. We're learning all about deploying SAP HANA into Azure here on Azure Friday.